Here on the left, you can see the two time domain transmission line equations that we just derived. There's one for voltage and there's one for current. Each of these equations has a derivative with respect to z and a derivative with respect to t. What we're going to do now is convert these two equations from the time domain to the frequency domain. We're going to use the assumption that the voltage and also the current are equal to some magnitude times the cosine of omega t plus some phase. If we wanted to write the cosine using Euler's equation, we could write it as e to the j omega t e to the j v. And then, if we did a derivative with respect to time, what we would get is j omega e to the j omega t e to the j phi. That's the same thing as having j omega v. So any place that we see the partial derivative with respect to t, we can replace it with j omega. So let's just do that in this equation. Right here, instead of the derivative with respect to t, that's going to be j omega I. And this right here is going to be j omega v. So let's write those on the right-hand side. Right here, we'll have minus dv dz is equal to r prime times I plus j omega l times I. If we combine these two terms, that's r prime plus j omega l, it's actually l prime, both of those times I. Here I needs to be the phasor term, and V also needs to be the phasor form, or minus sign there. Now let's do it for the current equation. We're going to have minus dI dZ is equal to G prime plus J omega C prime times V. So here are our two telegrapher's equations written in the frequency or the phasor domain. We're going to use those probably more often than we use the time domain equations because they're easier to manipulate.